interestingly enough, a lot of the compliance regulatory regimes out there, if the thing you care about is availability, which is typically what a DDoS attack is targeting, nobody's sort of got a regulatory model that says, hey, you must have availability of this level or this height, this amount of capacity for this service for these consumers, right? And that's sort of a big thing, right? And so you look at that, if you look at our infrastructure, right, at Verisign, is, you know, what's our transaction servicing capacity, right? At the end of the day, I need bandwidth and I need packets per second and the ability at the processing layer to be able to compute and to respond to people that are consuming our services. And so we've got some threshold well above biggest attacks that you want to be able to provision your infrastructure. But you know, generally, from a large DDoS attack perspective, I suspect that the biggest attacks we see today are only a function of the ability of the target to actually count that attack, and their upstreams to provide that bandwidth to them. Right? I don't think it's a firepower problem from the attacker. I think they're probably overwhelmed upstream in most cases, if that's an issue. And so, and it's kind of a the numbers are one thing, but if you also worry about availability, I think when I look at availability of our infrastructure again and think about the threat landscape, you know, there are certain keyboards where you need two-party systems or other things so that, you know, one keystroke as opposed to 50 terabits of capacity could cause the same amount of problem. And so is it a volumetric frame, you know, thing, or is it that one targeted attack that could be problematic? So again, it doesn't tell the whole story, but it definitely tells. It's really important to look at those metrics, but if you operate infrastructure, you probably ought to be looking at both sides of that spectrum.